बेसिक एलिमेंट ऑफ स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनेजमेंट इज द स्ट्रेटेजी फॉर्मुलेशन, स्ट्रेटेजी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन एंड स्ट्रेटेजी एवोल्यूशन. ओके, द कॉन्टेम्पररी इश्यूज ऑफ द स्ट्रेटेजिक मैनेजमेंट इज द विजन, मिशन, गोल्स, वैल्यूज, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, प्रोग्राम्स. दीज आर द कॉन्टेम्पररी इश्यूज. ओके, हाउ टू फॉर्मुलेट द आवर प्लानिंग प्रोसेस, it defines the and how to implement our planning and how to evaluate the our planning process. These are the called as strategic management. Okay, the strategic management is all about identification, description of the strategies that manages that carry so as to achieve better performance and competitive advantage for the organization. An organization is said to have the competitive advantage of the profitability higher than the average profitability for all companies in its industry. Okay, and in through planning process, through proper strategy formulation, we get the more profit compared to the average profit. Okay, this is the main aim of the strategic management. It is also defined a bundle of decisions and acts which manager undertakes and which decides the results of the firm performance. Okay, which strategy is ideas is in a lot of things. It's also a bundle of decisions. But we chose the right decision. We will take the right decision because it is not only individual person strategy, it's also depend on the our company performance based on this strategy. The managers must have through the knowledge and analysis of the general and competitive organizational environment so as to take the right decision. Okay, based on the SWOT analysis, where SWOT means strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats. They should make the best possible utilization of the strengths and minimize the organizational weakness and make use of the arising opportunities from the business environment. They should not ignore our threats. Okay, where strategic management is not nothing but a planning for both predictable as well as unfeasible contingencies. Okay, see this one. A strategic management not only it is not in a red carpet. It's also including the threats and it's also including the weakness. We maximize our opportunities and we know our strengths based on the SWOT analysis. We formulate our strategies. Okay, this is the strategic management process. In this strategic management process, identify the current vision, objectives and strategies. Based on this, we analyze our environment. Okay, in this environment, we identify the opportunities and threats. And also, we analyze our resource. Based on this resource, identify our strengths and weakness. Our identification of these opportunities, threats, strengths, and weakness, we form our strategy. This is the formulate of the strategy. And then, based on this formulation of the strategy, we implement this one, our strategy, and then we evaluate the results. Based on the results, we change our mission, objectives and strategies. Okay, see this one. Strategy management nothing but a planning for both predictable as well as unfeasible contingencies. It is applicable to both small as well as large organizations, as even the smallest organization face the competition, and by formulating and implementing accommodative strategies, they can attain the sustainable competitive advantage. We see that both large companies and small companies, they have both companies having the, based on the size of the organizations, they have in the opportunities, threats, they also having strengths and weaknesses. What is the threats is identified in large organizations. In large companies having the lot of threats because it is the branded companies. People always expecting the, from these companies quality of the products, and at same time they expecting the lower price, and a lot of competition is involved in this enrollment. These are the threats of the large companies. In small companies, they having also based on the size of the company, they are having also threats. The smallest companies, that is the first of all, resource lack of resource is not available, and also competition is also available in this market, and new branded products are not purchasing the easily, because people always wanted the branded. First of all, they believe the customers. These are the basic elements of the. These are the elements. This is also called as the threats of the smallest companies. And also strengths is the is similar manner. They having the strengths, weakness are involved in this companies and also small companies. It is the way in which set of objectives and proceed about the attaining them. It deals with making the implementation of the decisions for future direction of the organization. What is the meaning of strategy formulation? We minimize our losses or minimize the our weaknesses and maximize the strengths. Based on our strengths, we formulate our strategy and minimize our weaknesses. In this way, we formulate our strategy. In that time only, we get the more profit. Okay. It helps to identify the direction which organization is moving. Management is a continuous process that evaluates and controls the business and individuals in which organizations is involved. Evaluate the competitors and set goals and strategies to meet all existing and potential competitors. And then reevaluate strategies on the regular basis, determine how it can be implemented, whether it can be successful or does it need the replacement. Based on the evaluation, we take the decision, change our objectives, change our plans, change our strategies, okay? Needful replacement based on our strategy evolution process. These are the contemporary strategic issues are the vision statement. It defines the company's business, its objectives, and its approach to reach our objectives. It tells about the vision. Where vision statement describes the desired future position of the company. The elements of vision and vision statements are often combined, provide the statement of the company purpose, goals, and values. Okay. A vision is defined as the desired position of the company. Where mission is the how reach the, our objectives. It tells about the our mission. Based on this vision and mission, this is the our company elements. These are the basic elements of the statements of the company, and it provides the statement and the company purpose of the goals and values. What is the meaning of vision? Already I'm telling about this topic. mission, vision, and goals, objectives. These are the strategic elements. Okay. Whatever I am telling them, these are the involved in this definitions. The effective vision statement having the following features. That is the unambiguous. It must be clear. It must be harmonized and with the organization culture and values. Its dreams and aspirations must be rational and realistic. Our vision statement should be shorter so that they are easily to memorize. Okay, and second one is the mission. The mission is how to read our objectives. It tells about the how to read our objectives. Where the features of mission is the it the more must be feasible and attainable. It must be it the action can be taken. Okay, it should be clear enough so that the action any action can be taken. It should be possible to achieve it, and should be inspiring to the management and staff and the society at large. It should be precise enough. It should be neither too broad nor too narrow. It should be unique and distinctive to leave an impact in everyone's mind. It should be analytical. That is, that it should be analyzed the key components of the strategy. Should be credible. That is, the all stakeholders should be able to believe it. Where goal is the desired future state or objective that an organization strives to achieve. Well-made goals have the following features. That is, there are the precise and measurable. These look after critical and significant issues. They are realistic and challenging, and they must be achieved in the specific time frame. These include both financial as well as the non-financial components. The financial matters, each goal having the classified into two categories. One is the financial goals and second is the strategic goals. These are also called as non-financial goals. Where financial goals is related to the return on investment and the growth in revenue. These are the examples of financial goals. Where strategic goals is the its focus on the achieving the of the our competitive advantage in the industry. This is also called as strategic goals. What is the meaning of objectives? Where objectives are the end results of the planned activity. They are stated quantifiable terms. Objectives are stated different various levels of the management. They should be specific and unambiguous, and they should be measurable. They should be attainable, and they should be flexible enough so that its changes are required. They may be incorporated easily. They should have particular time horizon within which it's expected to be achieved. They should be help in achieving our organization mission and vision. They should be challenging. These are the features of objectives. They are classified into different types of organization objectives based on the size of the organization, level of the management, organization culture, and social responsibilities. Based on this, the objectives are classified. There are many factors impact the formulating the objectives in the organization. These factors are kept in mind in making the objectives. The factors are size of the organization, level of the management, organization culture, and social responsibilities. The objectives are various types. That is, the first one is the profit objective. In this profit objective, it is for any business enterprise, in order to earn profit, an enterprise has set a multiple objectives in the key result areas such as the market share, new product development, quality of the services. These are the examples of profit objectives. Where The term performance objectives is including the marketing objective, productive objective, product objective, sociological objective, financial objective, human resource objectives. Where marketing objective means it is expected from the percentage increase or decrease market share. It is the it is related to the functional area. Where productive objective is expressed in terms of ratio input to output. The objective may also be stated in terms of cost per unit of production. Product objective is expressed in terms of product development and product diversification and branding. Social objective may be described in terms of social orientation. It may be tree plantation or provisions of drinking water or development of parks. Financial objective is related to the cash flow, debt equity ratio, working capital, new issues, stock exchange operations, collection periods, debt instructions. These are the financial objectives. Human resource objectives may be described in terms of absenteeism, turnover, number of agreements, strikes, and lockouts, etc. These are the examples of human resource objectives. What is the meaning of policy? The policy is the broad guidelines for decision making that links the formulation of the strategy with its implementation. Companies use the different policies to make sure that employment throughout the firm make decisions and take actions that support the corporation vision and its objectives and strategies. The meaning of strategy is the planning. Simply, it's called as a plan, a strategy of the corporation. Their competitive master plan starting how corporations will achieve the vision and its objectives, and it's maximize the competitive advantage and minimize the competitive disadvantage. The typical business firm usually consults three types of strategies: corporate strategy, business strategies, and the functional strategies. What is the definition meaning of programs? A program is a statement of the activities or steps needed to accomplish a single use plan. The purpose of program is to make a strategy action oriented. The managers of divisions and functional areas worked with their fellow managers to develop programs, budgets, and procedures for implementation of the strategy. The elements of corporate planning process is the total system planning, which involves the determines the objectives of the company whole for each department. Formulate of the strategy for attaining these objectives, all being doing the background of SWOT analysis. Anushna, already you discussed about the processing of the strategy formulation, strategic management. The process involves the strategy formulation, strategy implementation, strategy revaluation. Based on this, before the strategy formulation, scanning the environment variables. Based on the environment variables, that means it's involved the topic is the SWOT analysis. And this SWOT means strengths. We can identify our strengths, weakness, identify the threats and opportunities. Based on the SWOT analysis, we analyze our environment, we analyze the resource. Based on these two elements, we identify our strengths, weakness, opportunities, and threats. Based on this, we formulate our strategy. after completion of the strategy formulation, we go to the strategy implementation, and then it evaluate this our strategy strategy based on evaluation. Any disadvantages is identified. Based on this, we change our strategy formulation. And this is the cyclic process, looping. See this one. The following main features of corporate planning is the total system of planning. It is not only individual planning process. Corporate planning is the total company oriented planning strategy. In this corporate planning, total system of planning under the concept of objectives are determined for the company as well as for each department of it. This means under this concept of the corporate planning, no department of the company is allowed to have its own independent planning. See this one, any organization, for example, one organization is involved in the corporate planning. Based on this level, format the strategy. And organization planning is the different from the individual planning. Because individual planning means the department level planning, a process levels and manpower, machinery, raw materials, this is the department level. And corporate planning means organizational level, how much input is given to the departments and how much total turnover of the company. This is the company oriented or corporation level is planned about this planning. To realize the objectives of the corporate planning, strategy formulation is done. Strategy formulation is the core aspects of the corporate planning. Success of the corporate planning depends on the success strategy formulation. Determination of the objectives of corporate planning and strategy formulation both is done against the background of the SWOT analysis. Already we discussed about these topics. Okay, SWOT analysis, we determination of the based on this determination of the objectives of the corporate planning and strategy formulation. These are the basic background of this SWOT analysis. Strategies are translated into tactical plans, which are detailed in nature. Okay, based on the formulation, strategy formulation, we implement the our strategy formulation implementation. Okay, tactical plans are put into the action at right time, decided by the management. This is the practical aspects of the corporate planning. Performance of the tactical plan is judged in the light of the objectives of the corporate planning, so that necessary modifications may be in the corporate planning process and better corporate planning may be done in the future. Corporate planning has a long-term perspective, which operates the plans have short-term perspectives. Where David Hussey is the define the corporate planning theory and practice defines the corporate. First one is the corporate planning include the setting of the objectives, organization work, people, systems to enable these objectives to be achieved. Motivating through the planning process, through the plans, measuring the performance, and so controlling the progress of the plans. Develop the people through the better making decision making. Clear objectives, more involvement, awareness of the progress. See this one. In this strategic management, based on our plan, we motivate our people. That means workers, low-level management peoples, co-workers, and general manager. This type of low level management for workers. We motivate the based on our plan and develop the decision making, clear the objectives. We know that they know about the our vision goal. Based on the, our goal, we prepare the our workers in that environment. The process of cooperative planning. The major steps involved in the cooperative planning are the first one is the environment analysis and diagnosis and determination of the objectives and strategy formulation, development of tactical plans, implementation of tactical plans, follow-up action. Okay. I show that the diagram of the strategy management process. You know about the you understand properly in that process, easily understand this total unit. Okay. Next one is the strategy environment scanning. In this environment scanning, based on this environment scanning, we analyze our environment variables. Based on this, we identify our threats, weakness, opportunities, and strengths. See this one, the purpose of the scanning is the identification of the opportunities, threats affecting the business for making strategy business decisions. As part of the environment scanning process, the organization collects information regarding the environment, analyzes it to forecast the impact of changes in the environment. This eventually helps the management team to make the informed decisions. Based on their analysis of the environment scanning, taking the decision, what is our strength? Based on our strength, we formulate our strategy. What is our weakness? Based on this weakness, we minimize our weakness and form our strategy. Okay. It collects information regarding the environment, analyze the forecast. See this one. This is the environment scanning. Input is environment scanning the strategies. Internal, what are the internal factors involved in this environment scanning? Perceive the environment change. Our strategy is changed. As seen in the figure above, environment scanning should primarily identify the opportunities, threats in the organization environment. Once these are the identified, the organization can create strategy which helps maximizing the opportunities and minimizing the threats. Before looking the important factor of environment scanning, let us quick peek the components of organization environment. The generally environment is already you told that business environment. These are the in this business environment, it's classified into two factors: only the internal factor and external and then the external factors. Internal factors, value systems, vision, objectives, organization structure, corporate culture, quality of human resource, labor unions, physical resource, and technological capabilities. Where external environments is the macro environment and micro environment. In this macro environment, organization, customers, competitors, markets, suppliers, intermediaries, where macro level environment is involved the economic, political and legal, technological, global, social and cultural, and demographic. These are involved in the macro environment. See this one in this internal and external analysis of the involvement. Organizational involvement consisting of the both internal factors and external factors. An involvement must have must be scanned so as determine development of the forecast of factors that will be influence of the organizational success. In involvement scanning refers to the positions and utilization of the information about the occasions and patterns, trends and relationship within an organization, internal and external environment. It helps to managers to decide the future path of the organization. Scanning must identify the threats and opportunities existing in the environment. While strategy formulation, an organization must take the advantage of the opportunities and minimize the threats. The threat for any organization may be opportunities for another. Where internal analysis, the involvement is the first step of the internal scanning. Organization should observe the internal organization involvement. This includes the employee interaction with the other employees, employee interaction with management, managers interact with the other managers, management interaction with the subholders, access to natural resource, brand awareness, cultural structure, main staff, operational potential. These are the examples of internal analysis of the environment. The interviews, surveys also to assess the internal environment. Where analytical of the internal environment helps to identify the strengths and weakness of the organization. Where external internals is the occasions, patterns, trends, relationships with the organizational internal and external environment. It helps the managers to decide future paths of organization. Okay. The business become more competitive and rapid changes in the external environment. Information from external environments adds crucial elements of effectiveness of long-term plans. As environment is a dynamic, it becomes essential to identify the competitors, move and actions. They have to update the corporate competencies, internal enrollment as per external enrollment. Enrollment factors are infinite. Hence, organizations should have agile and vigil to accept the adjust to the enrollment changes. For instance, monitoring might indicate that organization forecast of the price of the raw materials that will be involved in the product are no more credible, which could be imply the requirement of the more focus of the scanning. Forecast and analysis create a more trustworthy predictions about the input costs. In similar manner, they can be changes in the factors such as the competitors' activities, technology, and market tastes and preferences. While external analysis, three correlated environment should be studied in the analysis: industry environment, immediate environment, national environment, broader socio-economical environment, macro environment. Okay. Our next topic is the value chain analysis. The value chain analysis is the series one, the internal value chain, raw materials, internal goods, manufacturing, marketing, sales, after sales services. These are the industry value chain, the basic elements of the industry value chain elements. After that, the company value chain manufacturing involves the inbound logistics, operations, outbound logistics, marketing, sales, and services. These are the basic elements of the company value chain manufacturing elements. फिल्म इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, प्रोक्योरमेंट, टेक्नोलॉजी. ओके, दीज आर द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द वैल्यू चेन मैनेजमेंट. द वैल्यू चेन मैनेजमेंट इट्स क्लासिफाइड इन द इंडस्ट्री लेवल एंड कंपनी लेवल. इट्स डिफाइंड वैल्यू चेन मैनेजमेंट analysis is the process. The firm identifies the its primary and support activities to add the value to its final product, and then analyze these activities to reduce the cost or increase the our differentiation. Value chain represents the internal activities of a firm engaged when it is a transform input to into output. Okay, the value chain analysis is a strategy tool used to analyze the internal firm activities. The goal is to recognize which activities are most valuable to the firm, which ones could improve to provide competitive advantage. In other words, by looking into internal activities, the analysis reveals where the firm competitive advantage or disadvantage are there. The firm that competed through the differentiation advantage will try to perform its activities better than the competitors would do. If the competence through the cost advantage, it will try to perform the internal activities at lower cost than the competitors. When the company is capable of producing goods at lower cost than the market price, or it provides the superior products, it earns the profit. Although the primary activities add value directly to the production process, they are not necessarily important than the supporting activities. The competitive advantage mainly derives from the technological improvement or innovations in the business models or process. Therefore, such surplus activities, information systems, R&D, general management are usually most important source of definition advantage. On the other hand, primary activities are usually the source of cost advantage, where cost can be easily identified for each activity and properly managed. Differentiation advantage is the VC value chain analysis is done differently when the firm competence differentiation rather than the cost. This is because the source of differentiation advantage becomes from the creating superior products, adding more features and satisfying varying customers' needs, which results higher cost structures. The basic steps of this value chain analysis. First one is the identify the customer's value and creating activities. After identifying the all value chain activities, managers have to focus on the activities that contribute the most creating customer value. For example, Apple product success mainly come out from the great product features. Other companies have high quality offering too, but from successful marketing activities. These are the example of Apple product value chain management. And second step is the evaluate the differentiation strategies for improving the customer's value. Managers can use the following strategies to increase the product differentiation customer's value. That is, they add more product features and focus on the customer service and responsiveness and increase the customization and offer the complementary products. These are the main features of the evaluate the definition strategy for improving customer's value. And last step is the identify the best sustainable differentiation. Usually, superior differentiation and customer value will be the result of many internal activities and strategies used. The best combination of them should be used to pursue sustainable differentiation advantage. And next concept is the SWOT analysis. Okay, the abbreviation of the SWOT analysis is the strengths, weakness, opportunities, and threats. The way definition is the maximize the strengths and minimize the weakness, and compulsory we release our opportunities and minimize our threats. These are the opportunities and threats are considered the external factors, where strengths and weaknesses consider the internal factors. In next class, we'll discuss about these topic: strengths, weakness, opportunities, and threats. Okay. What is the strengths? What is the weakness? What is the opportunity and threats? How to, based on the SWOT analysis, how to formulate our strategy? Okay, these are all the topics is discussed in later. Thank you. ఏమో అటెండెన్స్ తీసుకొని నాకు ఫార్వర్డ్ చేయండి.